Hey guys, so in one of my videos in which I talked about what it takes to become a social worker or some one person, this YouTube user name is KpopFanXX93, I think, asked me some questions about social work, and I thought, hey, these are great questions. I'll just kind of talk about them in video form. I did respond in comments too, so in case this person misses this video, which is totally fine, that person can read my comment responses, but I thought these were pretty interesting questions for me to talk about, so I will get to talking about them. Now, before I get to that, I do want to mention, I said before that so there's two things that are required that is unique to the social work kind of education, in that to become a social worker, to get that master's degree in social work, you have to do two things. There's process recordings, which is kind of social work jargon, but it's pretty much remembering everything, you know, if you had a client interaction, remembering everything that you said, writing it down, and reflecting back on it, and writing about that. That's process recording. And I think social work profession is the only profession that does this. And also, what is unique to social work education is that field placement or internship is mandatory. And I said in the video that the requirement is 21 hours a week of internship. Actually, I'm wrong, because that requirement is a requirement in NYU. I did not realize, I'm starting to realize there are many things that are only specific to pretty much NYU or other schools of social work, but it's not applicable to all schools of social work. So, as far as I know, the 21 hours a week requirement is true for NYU, all the schools in New York City, pretty much, you know, like Hunter's College School of Social Work, Columbia School of Social Work, Columbia University School of Social Work, Fordham University School of Social Work, all those colleges, universities, you're going to be expected to do 21 hours a week of internship in order to get a social work degree. But apparently that's not true for all schools for social work. For example, I looked up New Mexico University. The requirement is like 11 hours or 12 hours. I'm not exactly sure. I think it's 11 hours required for internship. So it really does depend on what school you go to. But bottom line is internship is required to be a social worker. Anyway, here are the questions that this person asks. This person is a first-year college student in undergrad and is very interested in pursuing a career in social work. So the first question is, should one major in social work or any social science field for undergrad? Before I answer this, actually, also a disclaimer, I'm not saying in this video that I'm like an expert to be answering these questions. I'm just answering them because, you know, I like to talk about things on YouTube, and because it's kind of applicable to me. I graduated with a bachelor's in social work, and I'm currently a graduate student majoring in social work. So, not an expert by any means, but this is kind of what I do. And so, this is just me wanting to talk about this topic. Anyway, should you major in social work as an undergrad student? I'm not sure. It's you know, to become a social worker, you know, a bachelor's in social work is not necessary. You don't need a BSW. You don't need an undergrad education for social work. You can have a bachelor's in anything else. Psychology, sociology, English maybe. I'm not even, you know, sure. But you can have a bachelor's in pretty much almost anything. It's your master's that's going to matter. And you can get into a graduate school for social work if you have a bachelor's. Maybe it's harder to get in. I'm not sure on that question. But what I do know is it can be helpful if you are pursuing social work degree. If you're planning to be a social worker, it can be helpful to have a bachelor's in social work. Social work is one of those interesting fields where if you do have a BSW, you can qualify to get into what's called advanced standing program, which means you can get your MSW in 1 year, right? You can just go to graduate school for 1 year and you will be set to get the MSW, which is pretty amazing. I didn't qualify for it because something about my GPA not being high enough, and also my I withdrew from two classes during my undergrad. So if you withdraw from any class during your undergrad, you are disqualified. So do not withdraw from any classes. Do well in undergrad, and yeah, it should be fine. But it's not a requirement to be a social worker to have a BSW. I think it is helpful if you're pursuing your MSW. The other question is how competitive it is to get into grad school. That question I'm going to skip because I don't really know. I graduated from NYU with the BSW, and I applied to NYU for my MSW, and I got in. And NYU is the only college I applied to for graduate school. I got in, so I'm not sure about the competitiveness of it. My general kind of advice is that, you know, you should try to do your best in undergrad. And hopefully, if you do well enough in undergrad, you know, you should be able to get into graduate school for social work, if that is your thing, if that's what you want to do. The next question is, describing your courses and how they relate are different from undergrad. So, you know, how is my undergraduate courses different from my graduate courses in social work? So I think graduate school has a bigger, I just started, so it's only been about like 2 months, maybe not even that, of me being in graduate school. So what I'll say for now, based on that little experience of being a graduate student, is graduate studies seem to be a lot more focused, and a little bit more challenging too. There's all these expectations, like you have to have all these readings every week. And then here are these papers that you have to write, these midterms, a final paper. Like, the biggest difference I felt was, the significance part was, in my undergraduate, my first class, we always had this, everyone kind of shared each other's names, we talked about the syllabus. The first session of a class, of a course, was generally, getting to know each other kind of course. But when I went as a graduate student, the first session, it begins. Like, we don't even share names, we just get right into the subject. I remember my policy course, the professor just started, hey, I have some questions for you guys. What do you guys think about this? And then it just went right into the lecture. Like, there's no, you know what I mean? So I think graduate course definitely has a bigger focus. And also, the undergraduate social work education, there's a lot of things that are not related to social work that you're still expected to take courses on. I had a lot of psychology courses, sociology courses, and NYU requires this essay writing course for its undergrad students, no matter what major you are. So I have that. I did have some electives like Spanish. Generally, I think graduate school is much more focused. And I think final question is regarding gender difference in the profession. Is there a pay difference in the social work between males and females? So I think this is an interesting question, I guess. Social work is predominantly a female-oriented field. There's more females in the social work profession than males, right? And this is true in social work education as well. In my undergrad, I was the only male student in my graduating class. The graduating class was really tiny. It was composed of 40 people. 45 people, and I was the only male student. Everybody else was female students. As a graduate student, I do seem to notice more males other than me, but generally more females than males, right? And this carries on to professions as well. There are more female social workers than male social workers. So that tends to be the case. Social work as a profession is also one of the most diverse professions compared to other professions on average. You know, there's a lot of people of color in this profession, black social workers, Hispanic social workers, immigrant social workers, gay and lesbian social workers, some transgender social workers, so not those very rare to see, but they do. Generally, this profession is, I think, much more diverse than many other professions. As far as the pay scale goes, though, it really depends on the organization. From what I know, if the organization is primarily composed of social workers, such as the organization that I currently intern for, then it happens to be the pay difference between male and female, not that big of a difference. Although, even in social work professions, the general rule, the general kind of tendency, not rule, the general tendency is that male social workers are, they tend to be in leadership positions. So like chief executive directors or in the board of directors, you know, male social workers tend to be in leadership positions, and therefore, because of that, male social workers tend to have higher average salary compared to female social workers. Isn't that ironic? You know, there's less male people in the social work professions, but at the same time, like every other profession, men still make more money than women in this profession as well. But I think that's a societal issue, you know, racism, sexism, sexualism, like discrimination based on sexual identity and sexual orientation, ageism, and things like that are structurally built in. They are institutional. Therefore, even within professions like social work that combat this, that like to claim itself as anti-oppressive kind of work, there's still oppression in this type of work as well, as evidenced by the fact that men make more money than women. But yeah, those are kind of my responses to the questions you had. Very interesting and thoughtful questions. I appreciated it, and I hope that you got something out of this video. Cheers.